Welcome back to my YouTube channel. I am Lord Forwind here playing Europa Universalis 4 as Japan in the My Nostrum initial release patch. So, been playing a lot of European or near European nations. This time I decided I'd take a wander to the Far East and mess around as Japan. So I've done it as a daimyo before and it's fun, but it's much more fun just to be the emperor and do it and annex the world that way. So in case you've never done it before, Japan is in this case the Ashikaga shogunate, and you have an additional 4 diplomatic relations. She's still actually over the relations limit, but every other single country in Japan is in fact your vassal. However, they can all band together and overthrow you, so your really only way to survive is to start annexing them, because you can't declare war on them. So let's see, start annexing, working with those people, work with those people, and we'll save those people. I can't actually start annexing anybody till 10 years have passed, and I have to have good relations. What do I want to do? It wants me to actually do the Takeda, so I'll actually do that mission instead. Okay, tick up one. I want to ally myself with... I can't ally myself with anybody. Korea doesn't like me that much, and the Ming are my rivals. Okay. Sort of nice. We'll do the incorporate Takeda into my country. The Takeda are nice because, first of all, they tend to do very well, but they also have the only gold mine in Japan. Also, they have now split up Japan into three distinct cultural groups, which never was a thing before. Luckily for me, as Japan, they're accepted cultures for me. So. Right now it's kind of hang on and don't let my vassals overthrow me for quite a few years. So, we'll say nobility cannot be bought, which I'll actually take that. How am I doing here? I can actually support a slightly larger army. The Hakdayama here are rebellious. Where are they? Yeah, they are. I should probably actually move to correct that in a bit. Right now I gotta make sure my country is functioning. I got an extra stability for being uncorrupt. Nice. So there's actually multiple ways of playing Japan. But overall you wanna unite it. I mean, Japan is united if I've taken all the lands, or I can, if I have enough land, I can kick all the daimyos out and then turn into the same nation. But it's much better to annex them all peacefully. However, it does mean I do have to have lots of diplomatic power and reputation to do so. Kyoto is a pretty good starting province, in all honesty. Gives me good base income to boost it up, so I'm positive. And I start with a pretty strong army. Of course, all my vassals. Yep, there is the war. So this is actually in the Warring States period, which if you've ever played Shogun 2 Total War, which I have a couple videos of, this is essentially the same time period. I'm actually going to disband my navy. It's not worth the cost at this point. Yeah, it's the same time period. So essentially, the Ashikaga shogunate, which I'm playing, has lost a lot of its imperial authority. And so now everybody, all the small hereditary feudal lords in the country, are all rebelling and fighting each other to gain power. And then essentially, they will eventually turn on the shogunate. In fact, they actually have very good starting ideas compared to me. Mine's just stability and discipline. They actually get... where is it? There we are. They start with an extra force land limit and they construct spy networks quicker. Of course, they also all have Kazai Bell against the neighbors due to the fact that it is the Warring States period. They all have a modifier against that. I'll get some more prestige at the moment. I will placate the local rulers so they're actually somewhat loyal. There we are. All my daimyos are in fact at the moment loyal, but that will change once some of them gain more land. So we'll see who comes ahead in the war. Whoever comes ahead in the war, I'll work on improving relations and annexing them once quite a few years passed. Other than that, unless I want to unite the cultures, there's not much else for me to do. Unless I want to go conquer the Ainu, which is a legitimate thing, but I can't at the moment. Whew, I don't actually know who's winning these wars. The Hosokawa seem to be winning their war, which is good. The Yamana are losing. The Shiba won their war. Okay. I guess I will stop improving relations with the Yamana and instead prove it with the Shiba. Okay. The Hosokawa lost land, so they're loyal now. There we are. Another country has been eliminated. Eventually, the diplomatic relations will be even. The Keita are winning their war against the Imagawa. The Takeda I've seen overthrow Japan, usually the most. There has been exceptions. The Shiba have done it a couple times, but the Takeda seem to do very well in that area. Just having a essentially infinite supply of gold helps. Military power or mercantilism? I'll take the military power for now. I can hit level 4 military tech before the daimyos do, I'll be much safer. Also, as Japan, we have the Shinto religion, which gives us extra morale for our armies, which is very useful. Higher general. And it's just a matter of sitting here. Okay, the Takeda, yeah, we'll let them marry into it. We'll also marry the Hosokawa. Okay, they've also become very powerful. The Seigi are still around. The Shiba are still disloyal. Okay. We'll hold where we are right now. The Date are losing to the Shiba. We're becoming a threat very quickly. Obviously, we're not getting as much income because the Shiba have gotten so powerful, they're threatening us as a nation. 58. I guess I'll just boost the income in the capital for the moment. Probably not the best thing to waste all my power on it, but I would like to be able to support at least another military unit or two. Seigi, Shiba do not want a royal marriage because they're disloyal. Six years and more money losing every year. Positive again at the cost of most of my income. The kid are getting stronger. The Hosokawa are actually oddly loyal. The Nanbu, I've never seen them emerge before. Interesting. must be the replacement for the Date, historically. I cannot place my relative on the throne in Japan. That would make it way too easy, I guess. The Shiba will win that war. I can't intervene in any of these wars, which is the downside of playing as Japan. You can't intervene to save anybody. So I'll just collect trade in Hong Zhao as well. Won't give me anything. 0.5. Yeah. Naturally, we'll aid this traveler. Okay. And I'm also going to reduce my army maintenance some, so I don't go bankrupt. I'd also like to be able to hire an advisor pretty soon. I don't know who, really. Preferably a military one. The other problem is I have a very bad ruler to start off with, a 1-3-1 ruler. The heir is genius, but he's too young at the moment. The daimyos tend to have pretty good stats. Yeah, 3-4-3, 4-4-4. Yeah, they're all better than my ruler. Including this guy, who's kind of young. Shiba is still not loyal. Great. Still am stronger than any single one daimyo. It's 3 or 4 when they unite that kill you. 4 years. Actually, 3.5 years, assuming it's, I think it's September I can start in, November. So, 4 years. I probably will want to take the Hosokawa lands first. I mean, yeah, Hosokawa would be a pretty good start. That would give me, what, 6 territories more? The Date are now at war with the Usagi. It's not the Date, the Takeda are at war with the Usagi. I'm not sure. I assume the Takeda will win in the end. Yep, they're gonna win. There we are. So that means the Takeda are even looking more promising to annex this nation. Let's boost my military power income some. The Ming, they can't even fabricate a claim on my land, I'm too far away. So it looks like I will be killing the Ming this game if I can get my hands on them. Korea's allied to the Ming, there's a surprise. Luckily, being not only Japanese with the 10 discipline, but also the 10 morale from Shintoism, means that early on, if I strike quickly and I take something like defensive ideas, I can easily smash China. I also have a higher base than... development than Korea. And once I shift to uniting Japan, I become, I believe, do I become an empire? I think I do. No, I don't. I just become a feudal monarchy. Okay, it's not too big of a problem. There we are. Takeda are winning. And the Hosokawa are beating Shiba. I just hope that at least one of my vassals is loyal to the point I can actually annex them. I'm down to four or five vassals, which isn't good. Yeah, the Hosokawa, I don't even know if they'll remain loyal at this rate. Year and a half, I guess. Right now, everybody's loyal. The Takeda still look really good to annex as well. Just Please don't start any war in the next year or two. The thing I like about the Shogun is the massive increase in diplomatic relations. Unfortunately, you lose that when you shift away from the former government, which is kind of sad. It would be nice to have kept it 560 halfway. I think I'm probably ahead of the daimyos at this point. 10 months. Lost the general. We'll appoint a new general. Sakawa attacking somebody else. This isn't good. This isn't good at all. Although, oddly enough, Uchi has more troops than the Hosokawas, though. Huh. Richer provinces, I guess? Maybe I'll start with annexing Takeda, in that case. August, September, October, November. I don't believe I can start annexing them when they're at war. Yeah, I can't. Great. Okay, stop that. And bang, start annexing the Takeda. I will also... I can't afford anymore. I'll eradicate that problem. It's gonna take a while. 5 years now. I'm gonna try getting a diplomat. I didn't get it, darn. There we are, diplomat. Let's fire the military guy. And then invest some more money. Now that shaves off a couple months. So. There we are, they'll stabilize. Yep, there we are. I will go to the merchants and say I want money though. In case of a war, I want to be able to rearm my troops pretty quickly. The Uchi are actually beating the Hosokawa. Takeda have attacked the Hosokawa as well. Okay, that's fine. They're already 16% annexed, unless they become immensely disloyal while not looking. This case just marched their armies right past each other. Wow. Okay, this is the end of the Hosokawa Empire. I'll accept the royal marriage from both of those provinces, or both of those daimyos. I think I'll shift away from annexing. They won't be able to take all of Hosokawa's land, so I'm not too worried. Yes. Uchi would be nice because they also control the trade area here at Chikuzen. Okay. Royal marriage with them, then I'll start annexing them. Okay. We'll stop improving relations with them at this point, and we'll start just staying really where we are at the moment. Actually, I can annex Sheba pretty quickly. I'll do that. Even if I lose all my diplomatic reputation, I should still be able to annex some of these other nations. Corruption, great. The Uchi are not going to be that happy once I annex the Shiba, I can't imagine. These are all Tsukeda. Takeda, maybe. Takeda, probably. Okay, next month I'll have Shiba. Got it. Still annexing them, it just takes a while. For now, I'll just ban these ships. I'll have to rebuild them later, obviously, when I move to attack Korea or something, but for now. They're disloyal, obviously. Placate them. They're disloyal again. What is it this time? Huh. Strange. Oh well. I'll deal with it. Oh, these guys are also wanting to get away as well. Are they allied to each other? Yeah, they are, that's why. Great. I only have 13 troops, I have 16. Those two allied together. So let's ignore the Date for the moment, and let's jump over here and try and grab Hosokawa's one territory if we can. I don't think I'll be able to. Great. Okay, well, I can at least do a royal marriage. Oh, I already have a royal marriage with it, don't they? Great. Can't do any of that. Extra money, though, that's nice. There we are. Spent most of my power, but I've at least got a positive income even with none of my vassals supporting me. Or two of them not supporting me, I should say. Stability. That's nice. Corruption is slowly ticking down. Takeda dying. Oof, this might be tough to stay alive. Oh well, we'll see. Like to do it peacefully, but I don't think this war will drag on for 8 years. If it did, I'd be happy, but I don't think it will. Ah, oh, shit, it'll tick down a little bit faster than that, because eventually I'll get my diplomatic reputation back. Taking duo was actually kind of a dumb move on my part. Oh, we'll make it a state, because eventually we're going to try and get all of Japan. The Ming are no longer a valid rival for me. Interesting. They must have outgrown me. No possible rivals? Strange. I have never seen that happen. Never seen that happen. Great. Three of my vassals are rebellious, and my last one is being killed. Himekwa declared war. Okay. Let's hope this works out here. Shoot. Forgot that my army has absolutely no morale at the moment. Okay, at war. Like 1 month more and I'll be able to go up a tech level though. Which is how they beat me, they hit the tech level first. Oh, bother. Takeda will be annexed next month though. Let's use my army here if we can. There. We should have a good amount of troops here now. We'll sneak attack them before they annex that. They take that castle. Oh wow, they have more morale than I do still. Great. We have more troops though. I'm not going to win that war, that battle. Okay, let's call up some mercenaries then. Yep, I know I'm taking out loans. Not the best move, but I need the military. Finish them off. Please just finish it off. Okay. I think I've actually got to smash this army before they rebuild anymore. Not gonna do it. Great. Let's raise another mercenary unit. That's all I can do at this point. They want land. Does that satisfy them? No, they want more land. There. That satisfies them. Let's actually go down here and smash these armies up since they're independent of each other right now. Oh, great. He brought reinforcements. Come on. This time what numbers went out? Ugh. How annoying. Okay, that's it. We're going to siege down their provinces, their cap, siege them down rather than actually fight them. Once we smash this little army here. I'm not happy about the way this war is going. Oh, they're offering peace. Okay. That was well done on my part, I guess. I'll just ban the mercenaries. Okay, what do we have here? These guys are currently loyal. These guys are loyal at the moment. Okay. Why am I so broke? I'll mothball those forts for sure. No, I'm not going to give the Ainu any land. Is that the size of my entire army? 7 troops? Well, that sucks. Oh, I guess I'll raise war taxes for now. I need to be able to raise another military unit or two. Let's fire my advisor for now. An army, of course. Let's try attacking them. Should win. Did win. We just accept peace or something. Well, the daimyos are definitely not going to do anything to help me in this war. Including actually have a military. No, wait, I do control to Kai now, so I can actually boost the gold income. That should help a lot. There we are. Inflation will be crazy for a while. You just stupidly accept peace already. I'll have to raise a mercenary army, I guess. I would like to conquer the Anu, but I can't at the moment. Oh boy. Another mercenary regiment, I guess. Just want this war to end so I can start annexing them. I think that's all I can say. Well, I can do 15. Why can I even do 15? Not because of my shipping. Guess that makes sense. There we are. Please tell me they want peace. It's getting closer. Next month. There. White piece. Start annexing. I can't annex them. Can I annex any of them? Not for another 6 years. In the meantime, they're just going to be getting stronger militarily. Actually, a couple of years I could do the Imoka before I could do the others. Alright. Is it the same with all of them? 73. Yeah, same as all the others. Oh, so many loans. Can't accept anything at the moment. Need more money. That should balance out. Might want to focus down the military area for a while. If the daimyos get to level 5 before I do, I'm doomed. Oh, they're so much stronger than I am. Lower the army maintenance, but hide my army for the moment. So if they do attack, I still have time to rebuild. I don't have an advisor, so I get the full 1 gold there. Could boost the income in Kyoto. It's not probably worth it at the moment. Five years before I can annex them. One cavalry unit. That's nice. Yeah, I'd like to take Okinawa at some point, but that's not the time to do so. This is going to take a while. Oh, back up to 16 or so. Tech-wise, I'm behind, obviously. Great. I need to have a big enough army, they don't even want to fight me. I think a little less. Let's put back on the music. I turned off the music earlier because it was loud. Let's put it back on now. Smartest move. It's a lot of money needed. 1 year. Outside of Namdu's territory in case they decide they want to start a war. Oof. has been one heck of a war just to stabilize Japan. Great. Another loan. Okay, now I can start annexing it. It's going to take far too long to just focus on them, so let's finish off these tiny little dynamos first. It shouldn't take that long. But we've started annexing them, the final vassals, so this would probably be a good point to actually pause this video. We're up to about 40-something minutes, so that is it for this video. Next time we should finish uniting Japan and then look to expand outwards, at least finishing off the Ainu and Rukuyu down here, and maybe Korea. So that is it for this video. Hope you guys enjoyed it. I will see you guys all next time on my Europa Universalis for Japan Let's Play. Bye for now.